What up, fight world? It's your boy Egon. I'm back with some more boxing. Interesting news. They just released a new fight. October 26th, Vyacheslav Senchenko versus Kell Brook. Now, to be honest with you guys, I'm not really thrilled for this fight. I'll explain in this video my thoughts and why I feel this way. Ultimately, I feel Kell Brook is a fighter with some talent. He has power. He's definitely a big welterweight. However, based on his level of opposition, I don't feel we have a good read on Kell Brook. I don't know what he truly can do until he steps in the ring with somebody who may bring the best out of him and get to show all of his talent. I know in the past he's had trouble, like fights with Carson Jones, the first fight. It looks like he has stamina issues. So I'd really be anxious to see how he looks against somebody who's going to bring the best out of him. And so far, based on his level of opposition, I'm not really seeing that. I was also really disappointed when the Devin Alexander Kell Brook fight, which to me was his stiffest test to date, because Devin Alexander is a seasoned fighter with a great resume. Devin Alexander, whether he won or lost, has been in there with Timothy Bradley's, the Urangos. He's been in there with fighters like Marcos Maidana, heavy-handed. He has a slick style. He's several fights into his 147-pound career, and to me that's the best opposition that Kell Brook would have faced up to this point. And the fight was canceled and is never rescheduled. There's three injuries, two of them coming from the Kell Brook side and one of them from Devin Alexander. Most recently, the third injury was from Kell Brook. So it pretty much leads me to believe that Kell Brook, his handlers, for some reason, maybe the money wasn't right or they thought it was too high of a risk. That Kell Brook maybe wasn't ready. That they did not want the fight with Devin Alexander because it's too many mishaps. If you look early in the year, I believe Zab Judah versus Danny Garcia was supposed to happen in February. Danny Garcia had a bruised rib from sparring DeMarcus Corley. He had like a rib contusion and he needed time to heal and wasn't ready in February. However, that fight was just pushed back. It still took place at the Barclays and it still happened. We still got to see how that fight turned out in April instead of the original date. So with the Kell Brook fight, they just completely say that the fight can't take place and they take it off the books. And earlier this month, Kell Brook fought Carson Jones, a fighter he's already beat. He had problems with him, but he fought him earlier this month. So if he was able to recover in a reasonable amount of time to the point where he could have fought Devin Alexander in July 13th, I think they fought, then why not continue with the fight and just push it back one last time and see what happens? It just seems like, based on the situation, they didn't want the Devin Alexander fight for whatever reason. And again, with Kell Brook, I really can't gauge him. I did an interview with DeMarcus Corley. I've been really busy, so I haven't put it out yet. That's coming soon. DeMarcus Corley had the opportunity to spar with Kell Brook, and he did mention that Kell Brook has a lot of power and he said some good things about Kell Brook. However, I still think that fight night is, I mean, it's different than sparring, of course. And I don't feel I have a good read on Kell Brook based on that. I have hopes for him, and I think he could do this. But truthfully, until he steps in there with the level of opposition that he's saying he's ready for, we don't really know. And then you look at parallel fighters who are trying to build their name up, people like Keith Thurman. And I feel I have a way better idea of who Keith Thurman is, his style, what he brings to the table. And that's based on the fighters that Keith Thurman is fighting. Keith Thurman moved up in weight, fought Carlos Quintana, who is an awkward, slippery fighter. And he put in work. And Quintana was no match for him. Keith Thurman also fought Zibic, who gave Andre Berto problems. So a really durable, I'm not going to say Zibic is an A-plus fighter or anything like that, but he's a tough, durable fighter who has been in there with people like Andre Berto and can make anybody's night tough, especially if you're not conditioned. He can definitely take a shot, has a chin. And he went the distance with Keith Thurman, and Keith Thurman did what he had to do in that fight, and he looked superior throughout the fight, and it was pretty much dominant. Keith Thurman most recently is fighting Diego Chavez, and that's a good fight. Another undefeated fighter. They're both undefeated. Diego Chavez undefeated with a high KO ratio. So I'm anxious to see what's going to happen on Showtime tomorrow with that fight. Either way, I think Keith Thurman's handlers are doing a better job of marketing him. Kell Brook says he wants to be a star in America. He says he's ready for these big title shots. He's ready for fights with, like, the big names at welterweight. However, based on his handlers or the path in which they're taking, I don't know that he's ready, and I don't know how to really gauge him. Again, pulling out of the Devin Alexander fight, that wasn't a good look. I believe he was a mandatory for Timothy Bradley, and he chose to bypass that fight and not fight Timothy Bradley to fight Devin Alexander, and then that fight didn't even happen, no way. So it's like he's skipping out of these primetime opportunities to become a star in America. In America, it is the land of opportunity, but you have to prove yourself. People aren't just going to resonate. And I think fighters like Keith Thurman and his handlers, his representation, fighters like Gennady Golovkin, who is a foreigner from Kazakhstan, I think his handlers are doing a better job of marketing him, getting him in fights that get him notice and get him exposure. Matthew Macklin, that was a tough test for him, and he made it look easy. And that's what fans will respect. If Kell Brook ran through Devin Alexander and did what no other fighter would do, that instantly propels his career in the States. So overall, it's not a Keith Thurman bashing session. I just not really a fan of the Senchenko fight. Senchenko, his best win is probably Ricky Hatton. And you got to look at the situation, not to take anything away. A win is a win is a win. But Senchenko was a bigger man. He also fought Ricky Hatton, who was known to balloon up in weight. They used to call him Ricky Fatten. Gained over 40 pounds or whatever. He was 200 plus pounds at his height and his frame, which is more than a person like Andre Ward on fight night. So there's no reason Ricky Hatton needs to gain that much weight. And it's not even a lean or muscular build. It's like fat. It's like flabby. Ricky Hatton, also a fighter who got stopped by Floyd Mayweather and Manny Pacquiao. Now, those aren't bad losses based on who he's losing to, elite level fighters. However, they're devastating losses after he retires for 3 years, and he abuses his body during that 3 years, eats whatever the fuck he wants, he parties hard, he's drinking, he was on the internet snorting coke on camera. So, I mean, this guy's clearly like beating his body up, abusing his body. He retired for 3 years, and it didn't look like he was really active. It looked like he had to really work to lose the weight and to make this comeback. And Senchenko stops him with a body shot late in the fight. Senchenko did what he was supposed to do. I mean, if you got a guy with ring rust, go to the body, because it's harder to recover from body shots. And that's exactly what you want to do, especially if a guy has been on a long layoff. I mean, if he's been on a long layoff, headshots one thing, but a body shot is really going to make the fighter feel the effects of their inactivity. So really, Senchenko did what he was supposed to do. He was the bigger man. He was the more active fighter, and he fought a guy who abused his body in his off season and was retired for 3 years. So again, it's a win, but it's not that impressive of a win. Senchenko also lost to Pauly Malignaggi. So I'm not really super impressed with Senchenko either, with his level of opposition. He's a solid fighter, but he doesn't seem like a world beater. So for Kell Brook to beat Senchenko, what does that do for him? It doesn't really put him with the top welterweights. Now, if Kell Brook got in there with a Marcos Maidana like Devin Alexander did and did his thing, I would give him a lot more props, because we know Maidana is tough. Maidana is seasoned. Maidana's been in there with the Amir Khans. He's been in there with Eric Morales, the Josecito Lopez. Maidana has a chin. He has power. That's more impressive to me. If he gets in there with Timothy Bradley, Adrian Broner, I would definitely be impressed. But even more realistic fights, a fight with Amir Khan. I mean, the guys were on Sky Sports, both talking shit to each other. Amir Khan said he bested Kell Brook in the amateurs. Kell Brook disputes that. This would be a huge fight for England, especially. Have that fight in Manchester, Amir Khan versus Kell Brook. I'd actually rather see that than Amir Khan versus Devin Alexander. Amir Khan, Devin Alexander, not a bad fight. I would definitely watch it, and I think it's an interesting fight. But Kell Brook versus Amir Khan, that has the potential to do some serious numbers, just because they're both from the same kind of area, both from England. They both have a past war awards. Devin Alexander and Khan looks like they're running into roadblocks about where the fight is happening, if the fight should take place in Dubai or not. Whereas a fight with Kell Brook and Amir Khan, the pre-fight hype has already been built up because the fighters don't really like each other and had to say whatever they had to say about each other. They're both from the same area, so England is the natural location where they're both from, where the fight could take place. And I think a lot of fans would pay and want to see it. Amir Khan, someone who has fast hands, who they say has a glass chin. Kell Brook, someone who lacks stamina, but has punching power. It's an interesting matchup. And I would much rather see Amir Khan and Kell Brook versus Senchenko and Kell Brook. I'd much rather see Devin Alexander and Kell Brook than Senchenko. I just don't feel it really propels Kell Brook's career. And based on the path his handlers are taking, Kell Brook still is not going to get any kind of credit. And that's because fans can't gauge where he is because he's not beating world-class opponents or people who are known to be durable or just bring something to the table. You had a tough time with Carson Jones, and then you stopped him in the second fight. But who is Carson Jones? Carson Jones is not this miraculous fighter. So the second win over Carson Jones, that's like personal redemption, but it doesn't really propel his career in my eyes. Even if Kell Brook fought Josito Lopez, I think that's a sturdy matchup. I think Kell Brook probably beats Josito Lopez. However, Josito Lopez is a guy we know is durable. He's tough. He's going to bring it and train. He still cares about the sport. And he's a tough customer, no matter who he fights. He's been in there with Mike Dallas Jr.'s, the Maidanas, the Victor Ortiz's, the Jesse Vargas's. He's been in there with these different fighters. He's tough. He has a heart the size of Texas. And you know he's going to try. I mean, he's been in there with people like Canelo's, who are much bigger. And he at least tried to enact his game plan. He was just overmatched and outsized, outgunned by the bigger Canelo. But at the very least, Josito is an interesting fighter who could force his opponent, win or lose, to dig down and go into the tool shed and use tools that they haven't had to use for other people based on his consistency. I think what Josito brings to the table is consistency. He's a fighter, he's like a termite. And if you don't stop him, he's going to keep coming. If you can't physically stop him, then he's going to keep coming and give it his all. So people like that, I feel, are much better fights for Kell Brook, and those are the fights that are going to make him a star in America. Right now, beating Carson Jones twice doesn't really do it for me. Beating Senchenko doesn't really do it for me. I again have much more admiration to the winner of Diego Chavez and Keith Thurman. Whoever wins that fight, that does something for their career to me because both fighters are undefeated. Both fighters have high KO ratio, so the best man that wins, it moves him up a notch. Kell Brook, if he beats Senchenko, I'm not really pressed. Kell Brook lost, or Senchenko lost to Pauly Malignaggi, who doesn't really have much punching power. And he lost at home, I think it was. Malignaggi fought him. So I don't know. I'm just overall not impressed with this match. Let me know what you guys think of this matchup. Do you love it? Do you hate it? Leave a comment. What's next for Kell Brook? What do you think? What do you think of him? Who would you like to see him fight? Leave a comment. As always, hate, comment, or subscribe. Till next video, it's Ego signing off.